Welcome back to our channel. If you've clicked on this video, we'll be showing you a forward-facing balcony cabin tour. We'll be doing the Iona ship tour in this video for you. So without further ado, let's show you around our cabin. So we're in cabin 9104, that means we're on deck 9. We're forward facing. So as you come into the room, first of all, you met with a card reader. You put one of your cards in. If you're in with someone else, put it in to get your electricity. There's a master switch just down below it for the cabin inner lights. And you have a lock button. You have your safety instructions on the back and your life jacket just in case. When you first come into the room and you board the ship, you're on embarkation day. There are channels on the TV to show you the safety features. And also, cute thing, we have here a magnetic, so you have gone exploring when you want your room to be made up. Everyone says taking it easy, and the magnetic, so you can... supposed to be magnetic, hang on. It does work. So, look, if you... It's supposed to... Look. It works, right? The whole point of it is it works. On the door, it works, so you can flip it either side. Okay, that's done. And obviously, just before... Opposite out, there's a bathroom here behind us. We have a coat rack. Obviously, you can see we've got all our coats here. It's very cold at the beginning of May here in the Norwegian fjords. So you can hang up coats, and we'll come into the bathroom. And just before we go in, you've got little hooks on here if you want to hang your towels up. Air conditioning control, so you can have it colder, hotter, or this will just keep it cooler quicker. And you've got your main lighting, but there's always tends to be sort of like a minimum ambient light on in the bathroom. You can see we've got a walk-in shower. You can actually, if you come in, you can show them how much space there is in the shower, so you can do, there's enough room to do squats, and you can jump in the shower if you want. I mean, there's quite a lot of room to, you know, move the head up and down depending on how tall you are. If you go in the whirlpools, which we'll show you around later on in the ship, there's a line you can hang up your wet cozzies, which is quite handy. As you see, you've got towel rails that come every day. If you do want new towels at the end of the day, you put them in the shower before they come in and clean. We've got loads of space to put your toiletries, like we have. If you're on the toilet and you think you're going to get caught out and you don't know where the toilet rolls are, they're actually just to the right side of the sink here, because I nearly got caught out the other day, so Ellie had to come and rescue me. This is a non-steaming mirror, by the way, so if someone does have a shower, and obviously light controlled by Ellie, that won't steam up, so you don't have to worry about that. Yeah, by the way, you can't do extracurricular activities in that shower, by the way, if you're wondering. So you can do lunges and that if you want, if that floats your boat or tickles your pickle. So if we're coming out, hey, as you can see, we have the bedroom here. So just so you know, some cabins are not laid out the same as ours. Some of them have the sofa here and the bed's a bit further back by the balcony. Wardrobe space here. There's actually quite a lot of coat hangers here. We bought our own coat hangers, but we didn't have to use them. I think we've got about 9 to 10 each of coat hangers. You've got a safety deposit box. You've got loads of shelves to put stuff in, and there's another little closet at the end for more storage. And either so by the side of the bed, you've got this main light here. There's a little reading light if you want to read in bed at night, which is quite handy. This side of the bed doesn't have a plug socket, but the other side does. There's one UK plug socket, and you've got a master switch. It's a master switch. Play around with them, you'll figure out what they do. And we've got some nice decorative mirror artwork on the wall, which is quite nice. This cabin's been like home to us for the last few days. It's been absolutely lovely. You've got little cubby holes just either side of the bed. Now, storage space. These cupboards, this is our snack cupboard. Let me show you. So we've put snacks in here, some other stuff. So we're showing you this. This is, we were supposed to be in port today at Hargesund. 35 knot gale force winds, and it's foggy, and it wasn't safe for them to put up, so that's why we're doing this room tour now. Yeah, they're quite asleep. If you bring any snacks on board, you can. One helpful tip, there is a fridge in this room. You can bring 12 cans each on board, which there's ample room in the fridge for. We've got a tea and coffee station here. There's a coffee and biscuits, and you've got milk, your kettle, and in here we have more space. There's a hairdryer will be in here for you ladies, and then you've got a workstation. So we've got the kettle's a European plug, so if you need an extra one, bring a European plug socket with you to plug something in. Then we've got two UK plug sockets here, ample working space, mirror, some storage. You'll find your in-room dining up here. This sofa is actually a pull-out bed if you have, I guess, some kids with you, or, you know, if you're into the frapple life, there's someone else can sleep in there. We have some storage space just down here. So when you're in the room, you obviously have a TV remote. We have the TV on the wall. You can see your onboard account. You can see the bow cam. Now, if you choose a room that's indoor, the bow cam is probably going to be very handy to you, so you know when it's daylight, so you're not going to be a vampire your whole life while you're on board the ship. Yeah, you've got the safety videos, bail camera and cruise radio. Better mute this quick because we'll get copyrighted. So like today, we'll show you the bail when it wants to work. We've had some difficult weather and that, of course. And then you've got navigation channels. So when you're on the cruise, it'll tell you where you are on the ship, ports of call, time you're supposed to arrive in port. This is the current wind speed, time and date. And you've got loads of other channels. When I say loads of others, you've got BBC HD, all that stuff. There's films and that on board. So if you want to stay in the room, you can, which is quite handy. And the one thing, I'll tell you what, the one positive thing about having this forward-facing cabin is the amount of amazing views we've had on this Norwegian fuels trip. We've set up the time-lapse, we've got the sailing into Stavanger, which is pretty impressive. Seen a nice sunrise in the morning on our first sea day, which was really cool. Olden is just, because you get the whole views going down the fjords, we've got the whole captured on film, which is absolutely amazing. Then Allison was a cool port of call with a ship at the reverse into the dock. I don't know how they've done that. And this, right, so our forward facing cabin kind of has a window in front, as you can see. That's to protect the wings. It's very windy out there at the moment and very freaking cold. But because it's windy out there, there's a knob you can use to unlock the doors on every cabin. You do need to put a bit of welly into this. Now, if this doesn't work, I'll insert a clip for you from yesterday. We'll try to open it because we had 25 mile an hour winds, but I'll show you. Okay, it's not that bad. If you come out here, I'll show you the deck. We have our deck here. Well, obviously we've got the amazing view of the bow of the ship. As you can see, it's very, very foggy out there today. And we've got chairs, obviously forward facing balcony. You're not going to get that glass because it's safety reasons. Obviously the sea is quite choppy. We can feel it quite a lot today. Quite nice watching sailaways, really nice around here. We've had some lovely time. Just wish it was bloody warm. We're going to go back in because it's freaking cold. So that concludes our room tour. What we'll do now is you will see us in a second and we'll show you the P&O Iona ship tour. We'll be starting off from the top deck and working our way down, because if you're smart, you don't want to walk up 14 flights of stairs. So we'll go show you the ship tour now. We're going to be showing you the ship tour. We're on deck 18 at the moment. Might be, if you see clips that are a bit hit and miss, we do apologise. So, because deck 19 is behind us, which is a very small area, and then you've got deck 18, which it just goes in different areas.
And Iona, she's a big girl, so it takes a little while to get around all the different decks and actually knowing where everything is as well.
Yeah, it's taken us about a day, but don't get me wrong, got lost before. We went to our room, we've got a forward facing cabin, and we went to the back of the cabin, and I was like, why are the rooms getting, like, the numbers are getting bigger? And then you've got an odd side and an even side, so we found the even side starboard and the port side's odd side. You can still get lost even though you think be big-headed and no way around the ship. So we're going to show you that around, we're going to show you that today. Hopefully you get a rough idea of where everything's going to be.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, let's get going on with the ship tour. Deck 19, this might be a little bit odd. So up here there's more seating, there's not really much to do up here, but obviously you can see the radars of Iona.
It's a quiet place to sit, so if you want some peace and quiet, this is the place to come, obviously, if it's warm enough.
Yeah, and if it's warm enough, you can roast yourself like a chicken as well. Around here, as you can see on the side of that ship, there's a plaque here that tells you where it's been built. And I believe Iona was built in Germany. Correct me if I'm wrong, yeah. Papenburg, Germany, 2020. And I believe Iona did her maiden voyage on the 22nd of April, 2022. Don't we love Iona?
We love Iona.
She's a bit deaf this morning. Apologies. Oh, look, we can see into the retreat up here. So I said use your imaginations. There you go, there's some sunbeds, nice sunbeds actually.
Proper got sunbeds.
Oh, you've got...
And beds, day beds.
Which is very nice. They've got their own little whirlpool down there. There'll probably be one either side, I imagine. And if you want to get a nice view into port, you can stick your phone under there. But if you lose it, don't come to us and sue us. You do that at your own risk. Towards the back of deck 18, there's actually a little kids club. I'll show you because there won't be no kids in here. No sprogs, but they've got a little climbing frame. All the other, yeah, so if you've got a little nipper, little sprog, little freaking froglet, or whatever you want to drop them off for the day, seen quite a few parents do that. You could, it's quite a good little play area for kids. And they do have kids clubs here on here for little ones on board. So the parents can have a nice relaxing time. And towards the back of the ship, there's not much more towards the back of the ship. There's the whirlpool. So on this deck, there's a few whirlpools. There's one back down there, but we didn't show you because it was a long walk between each area. So we've got a whirlpool this side, there's a whirlpool that side, there's one more area just up here where we'll show you in a minute. One last area we need to. So we've got a overview of the main deck area, which we'll show you shortly, is the infinity pool, looking at the back of the ship. And look at, I mean, what a day for a view. Look at that, sunrise to the east of us. You can see the ship's trail at the back. We're going a little bit slower than normal, because we had a non-port day yesterday in Hargesson. We had rough seas, 35 knot winds. So currently the ship's doing 14 knots instead of 22 knots, just to, you know, keep our itinerary and holiday the same. I'm grateful for a very nice sea day today though. But up here is the last bit, so we'll show you this on the top deck before we show you the lower deck. This is the last bit of the top at the back of the ship. This is classed as like deck 18-19. So you've got a panorama sports area. There currently is a pool behind us, but I can't show you because there's people swimming in it. And if we go up these stairs, we'll show you the sports area. So this is actually the first time we're seeing this. This area is for golf nets. So if you can actually see, if we come around here, normally they have basketballs and golf clubs. If you move that, I'll show them what's in here. Oh, nothing. Towels, no, nothing. Bit of a shock. So golf net rule, sports court. They do little basketball competitions. There's golf clubs all stored there if you want to have a ball. I don't know where you get the balls from. Splash zone for your little sprogs. Look how cute this is. Cute little water park. I guess this will be open on warmer days. It's been quite cold at the moment. So, I mean, this is a cool little area for your little kids. And we have, obviously, the jogging track. We do, if you want to do a nice walk along the ship, I recommend deck 8. Come over to the side a bit. It's nice walking areas, especially you've got a day like today with a nice sunrise.
Yeah, I also feel like deck 8 does the whole ship. I'm not sure if this does.
No, this doesn't.
No, so deck 8, you can literally do the whole length of the ship.
Oh, fun fact. We tried to record how long the ship is, but because we're moving at 20 knots, our average mile for a power walk is about 13 minutes. It kind of went off after 3.5 minutes. I was like, man, that was
Jesus,
quick.
Jesus, wow.
Obviously, because the ship's going really quick and the GPS got a little bit confused. When you're coming on the ship, there's 3 sets of elevators, and when you come on the ship, each deck will have where places are on the ship. Oh, and another annoying thing, it does this as well. It just changes on its own.
Yeah, and it's not a touch screen, so you have to wait for it to roll over again as to what you're looking at.
But you can get an idea where things are on the ship though.
Yeah.
With these, can't you? Yeah, so there's 3 parts. You've got forward, and the forward parts of the ship will be noted with the blue decorative on the stairwells. Mid ship, you've got white, and then after the ship will be brown.
Red.
So it's red. I say brown. It looks more brown than red.
It's definitely red.
Let us know down below if you think it's more red or brown.
It's red.
I think it's brown.
No, it's red.
It's definitely brown.
Red.
You need your eyes tested. These lifts can get very busy on embarkation though, because the porters and that are using them for the suitcases. They're busy anyway. And if you come here, deck 17, we have
the Ivory Suite, Epicurean, and the Crow's Nest. So we've got here, we've got the Ivory Suite. I'm not entirely sure, but I think it's where you can get married on board.
Yeah.
So it's like a sort of a little venue that you can get married at. And then we have the Epicurean. We've not eaten at this restaurant, we've heard that it's very good. Again, they don't do that many vegetarian options, so we've just decided not to eat at this one on this time.
Yeah, and they do afternoon tea here as well, because you can't get afternoon tea in the main dining rooms no more.
No,
they've stopped that on Iona.
On Iona, if you want to have afternoon tea, I'd probably book that before you even get on board, because when we come on board, everything had sold out, it'd been fully booked.
If you've got early embarkation, get on that Myholiday app ASAP.
Yeah, or you can book it before you get on through the website. And then we have the Crow's Nest, which is a bar and a lounge. Yeah. This is really nice because it's right at the front of the ship.
Yeah.
But you do have to, so if you do come here of an evening, a dress code.
Well, what do we call it? Oh, swanky wanky.
Swanky wanky.
Swanky wanky.
So there's loads of lovely seats. You've got a piano,
nice.
And they do have sort of people coming to play the piano and sort of live singing as well in here.
Yeah. I mean, this is the very front of the Crow's Nest. Look, you've got nice view. So this is our state of the North Sea at the moment. So this is very nice.
Yeah, we sat in here yesterday. It was lovely.
Wasn't it? Loved it. We weren't dressed swanky wanky. We just wore normal stuff.
No, but I think in the day you're fine. It's of an evening that you have to wear, you know, proper shoes.
Exactly.
Shirts. That sort of thing. Swanky attire.
Yeah, we're going to go up these stairs now from the Crow's Nest. There's a little swirly stair. I'm not sure where it goes, but apart from this deck 17, it's all kind of outdoors. So we'll go and show you. These are the spiral. Please say it's open, because yesterday we come, it was closed because of the wind.
Up here you've got the Beachcomber Pool and Bar, the Retreat, and the Sun Terrace.
Please don't tell me I'm wasting my time. Oh no, it's open. I think they just closed it off yesterday due to the unsteady conditions on the ship.
Also, this area is exclusively for adults.
Yeah.
You can't bring children up here.
Woohoo! All good positives. So this pool wasn't actually filled up the other day on our first sea day, was it?
No.
Yeah, look, this is nice, a beachcomber area. Lovely, this was rammed the other day. They had a net over the thing because the pool wasn't. But that's a heated pool. Look, you can see steam coming off that. How cool is that? I wonder why I've seen nutters in the pool first thing in the morning. And then where this staff member is, this is a paid area, the retreat. I think it costs like £20 or £30 for the day in that area, so we can't show you it. And poke the camera up. That's all you're gonna get, I'm afraid, guys. Just use your imagination, your wildest imagination when you're 4 years old, and paint a picture of what it looks like. That's what you'll get. You've got loads of seating around here in the adults area only, and they're getting the sunbeds out because they know we're gonna have a nice sea day today. Nice final sea day. As again, when you're on the top floors, there's always be, where there's whirlpools and pools, there'll always be used towels and clean towels stored in these little storage areas. We are at the back of deck 16. There's a little kids play pool here. And there's an infinity pool just over the back. We also have a little bar just around here as well. But the infinity pool can get quite busy, especially on a sea day, and it's nice weather and not rough like we had the other day. It gets quite loud around here, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But you're protected from the wind. If you've seen any other videos, people say, oh, the grab and go section, you can grab food here. We're here on 4th of May sailing on Norwegian Fuels, obviously. If you've watched our two-part series, I recommend you do go watch that after you've watched this ship tour and our balcony tour. It's never been full, is it? This whole trip.
I've never seen anything in it.
I don't know if that's because since it started when she did her maiden voyage in 2022 because of... I'm not going to say the word.
The word.
Yeah, first thing I'll do. So we'll go through here. The main restaurant, when you come up through the back of the ship, you have to go through the Horizon restaurant and the beach house to get through to the Sky Dome and some of the other areas on the ships. When you come up through the back, you can go left or right. It doesn't matter which way you go. You'll end up in the same place. It does get easy to work your way around this ship. It's not that hard. It took us like a few days, didn't it?
Yeah.
So in the buffet, you've got all your cereals in the morning. This will change, obviously, lunch, dinner.
You've got
different milks.
You've got different milks. So you've got Alpro soy milk, sort of no sugar jams. You've got another one of those tea, coffee and juice and water stations.
One of the main areas on the ship people do forget about, you can get your hot water, you can get your coffee, your tea, your milk free while on board the ship. And you can get apple juice, orange juice, pineapple juice only at breakfast time. Keep that in mind. You can refresh yourself during the day. And they do other breakfast staples along here. Do you want to...
We haven't eaten breakfast here. So you've got mushroom omelettes, you've got fried eggs.
Oh, most importantly, this is open first thing in the morning, 6:30, the earliest one open.
Fried
so if you
bear.
Need to... Oh, sardines, a bit weird for breakfast.
French toast. So this is like continental breakfast. So you've got fruits, yogurts, granola, muesli, smoothies. You've got the breads, waffles.
Chocolate fondue.
Chocolate Nutella, obviously. Nutella is chocolate. You've got a sort of cook stations, and then it kind of repeats itself. Got another part of the buffet. It's going to be exactly the same as what we've just shown you. And you've got ample seating as well. It's quite nice. A lot of them have window views as well. And then we're coming up to the beach house restaurant. Yep.
This is repeated on the other side of the ships. It's not just this area where we're in. We're on the starboard side. But yeah, this has probably been one of our favourite restaurants here, isn't it?
Agree.
Nachos are great. We did have one issue where they double charged us our drinks, even though we only had one lot. So make sure you check your My Holiday app and your expenses as you're going along.
We're eating here again tonight.
For our last sea day.
Our last day on board.
Oh, and the main event. So this area in the Sky Dome is busy during the day with kids in the pool, because this is one of the biggest pools probably on the ship in the Sky Dome. And you can see shows. What did you get here? Silent disco. So much fun here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, brilliant. And
we've got another whirlpool here, inside whirlpool. This was rammed yesterday.
Oh, there's another one over there as well.
There's opposite. Another one. And then you've got this pool here. I think they're setting up for some sort of show.
Oh, yeah, they've got...
This is the biggest pool. And it was rocky yesterday. The sea was quite rough yesterday. And you could actually see this water sort of moving. It was and then upstairs you've got loads more seating.
Yeah, we recommend sitting there if you want to get a good view of the shows early. I'd probably come, say, half an hour early before show starts.
And then you've got a bar somewhere, but I don't know where it is.
It's just up there in the corner.
You've got a bar up there as well, so lots of seating.
We've got another ice cream bit down here, but there is another water filling station up here on, we're on deck 16 and it'll be just where we come from the Horizon restaurant, and we found it's the coldest water you can get on the ship, whereas the other one's by the Keeling Cow, and there's one on deck 6 there, a little bit warmer, but all three water stations.
Another bar, and then this is Sundays, which is another ice cream parlour. This one gets quite busy because, like James said, there's lots of children here during the day.
Yeah,
and then we
nice.
Also have Taste 360. It's like a fast foodie type joint. During the day they do pizzas, they do burgers, hot dogs, they've got like a little salad station, and then they also have street food. So they do rotisserie chicken, and then they do street food, but I've seen it different, where they have like Norwegian food. It depends on your sailing, but they had Norwegian food, which has a lot of seafood.
Yeah.
But here they have pasta, penne pasta bolognese.
Oh, by the way, the pizzas here, some people say, oh, the Olive Grove's pizzas, but I'm a pizza connoisseur. I've eaten a lot of pizza, I can tell you what's good. The pizza's all right here, the Olive Grove's all right. There's no difference to them, really. I don't think the Olive Grove's slightly better, but because we're on a ship, they can't get wood-fired pizzas, because obviously you need a fire in a ship, and it's a health hazard having a ship out at sea having a fire, so they're all done on electric ovens, basically.
Yep. And this is a nice place to sit. I mean, it doesn't even do it any justice because of the sunrise, but this is actually a really nice place to sit of an evening if you can get a seat, because if you do go to Norway, obviously depending on what time of year you go, the sun doesn't set till really late, so you can still see out to sea at like 10 o'clock at night.
Or midnight sun. If you come June time, it'll be like midnight one, it'll get like 2 hours of darkness or something. It's setting at 10 a.m.-ish here, maybe even a bit later than that, isn't
10
it?
10 p.m.
10 a.m. Jesus, anyone think we're in the middle of winter? Okay, deck 8. This is one of our favourite decks. We have the Keeling Cow on this deck. Now, there are exits out onto deck 8. It's the main walking deck. If you like walking around the deck, it's the biggest deck. And there's whirlpools, hot tubs around there, and you can see the back of the ship, the trails of the ship, can't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, we've done a lot of laps of the deck 8.
Hell of a lot.
Yeah.
And just to note, there's actually a water fountain here, which actually I forgot to mention. There is one on deck 6 as well in the grand atrium, just near the art gallery. So you can come refill your bottles, it's free, don't worry about that. And then we're at the top floor of the grand atrium now. The Keeling Cow, there's a podium, you can book your food. We have a bar along here, and obviously you can look at the nice views of the whatever sea you're sailing on. This where it gets really good, guys.
Again, the Keeling Cow is essentially in the grand atrium, which I find a little bit strange.
Yeah, it just doesn't look like people are ever like eating.
No.
So we have another little shop here. This is where you sell all your sweets. You can get you like your Pringles or your kind of other stuff, pick a mix if you fancy it, a bit of Lego. And then here we have the Ripples, which they do Sundays. You can get your ice creams. This is all chargeable extras. There are prices for the different Sundays. Some of them, we've had a couple of ice creams with a cone.
Prices aren't bad, actually,
no, they're not
to be
bad.
Honest with you. I don't think they're too bad.
No, they're not bad at all, but a very nice ice cream. You can get ice cream afternoon tea, actually. I don't think we've got this, but they'll serve it in something like this. This is all refrigerated, so it's not for show. It's actually edible, and then do their own little magnums.
Next up, we've got Sindhu, which is like an Indian restaurant. We're not massive Indian food fans. However, we did decide to eat here on Gala night.
Yeah, and it was very nice food, wasn't it?
Or celebration night, and the food was incredible. Like, really, really good.
Didn't shit out lung either, because it wasn't that spicy, so win-win for me.
Yeah, we just asked them with everything with no spice, and they delivered. It was really good.
It's incredible food. So we have a seating area around here in the Keys. We're just coming up to the Keys, one of the best bits on deck 8. FYI, always hand-washing stations everywhere. So if you need to wash your hands, recommend doing them. And there'll be hand gel stations. So around here, this gets very busy during the day. You can eat, obviously the main purpose is they actually serve breakfast here, and it opens at 7 a.m. So as you can see here, you've got all the different breakfast options.
So you've got three counters. You've got hook, line and vinegar, which does fish and chips throughout the day, afternoon. You've got Fusion, which is an Asian kitchen, and then they've got Broadwalk Diner, which is like an American diner type thing. So yeah, they do like American pancakes, waffles, omelettes, full English breakfasts. We've had the buttermilk pancakes, and they're really good.
Very good, aren't they? Yeah, they're small, so if you want a few, just ask for like two lots, because they give you three. They all have cutlery outside, so grab your cutlery. When you do order, they will give you a tray, so don't pick up a tray, because it's like kind of pointless. You've got your ketchup and mustard station. another area to get onto the deck 8. We have a, so actually this one of the important things people don't know is you can actually get free tea, coffee, milk and water throughout the day on the ship at breakfast time. They'll put out some, because we're here for doing this at breakfast, they'll put some breakfast stuff if you just want to come grab some of this stuff separately, croissants and muffins.
Did you pay no chocolates here?
Yeah, but we might have to grab one later. Yeah. We've got bread rolls, fruit salads during the day, they'll put desserts out. And then you've got your tea and coffee stations. As you see, we took a while for this, but this actually, you can get apple and orange juice in the mornings only, not in the afternoons.
Yeah, but you can get water there throughout the day as well.
Yeah, a place for used tea bags, spoons. If you stir in a cup, see there's a little hole next to the tea bag. That's where the used teaspoons go. And then we have a zit olive grove. Now, one thing we've got to mention actually is this is the only place where you pay £1 for chips extra, but you can get chips around the corner at the American Grill. You can get chunky chips at a hook, line and vinegar. And up on deck 16 where the Horizon Buffet is, you can get French fries there for free.
Yeah, so this restaurant, you don't have to pay extra for. There are some extras on the menu that you will pay extra for, like James said, chips, and there's a few others as well. We've eaten here twice, and it's okay. The food I had last night was very good. It was really, really good. But the service is a little bit slow in this restaurant. We found that this is the slowest serving restaurant.
Yeah, I think they've had staffing issues because when we were there yesterday, like we got 8 or 7, they're like, oh, we don't have availability till 8:30, but there's a million tables free, so all right. And then our last place, I don't know if we'll be able to go in because we're quite early. We have the clubhouse towards the back of the ship. There'll be another main entrance, and this part gets very busy. Like, when I mean very busy, we'll go through here and we'll show you the back of the ship and the whirlpools. But this gets really cool. It smells like it's been lived in, this, from all the DJ stuff last night. But when you're sitting around, oh, there was a screen. So as you can see, there's a screen there. They do like kids' magicians. So they've got little play areas around there.
Little kids' play area.
And then we've got the main show. This is where bingo will be held, by the way, which is good fun if you want to try your luck.
And if you get a seat that's not sort of facing the stage, there are screens everywhere, or there's quite a few screens everywhere, so you can sort of see what's going on the stage.
There's one there as well, like that. And there'll be ones at the back here in the corner. And
but you'll be very lucky to find a seat. We've only had one night where we've actually had a seat here.
Yeah, tell me, I don't want to stand up the rest of the night, but you, if you want to play the waiting game, someone will give up their seat. And we're at the back of the ship, so we'll show you this. Outside.
We're out at the back of, or the aft of the ship.
It's called the Sunrise.
This is called the Sunrise Bar. We haven't actually been out here for Sunrise. Sunset Bar, sorry.
Sunset bar, yeah.
It's a Sunset Bar. I can imagine, obviously, if the weather's good, this would be a really good place to come and get some sundowners. And you've got lots of tables, and you've got two massive whirlpools.
Yeah, there's that one there really behind Ellie. They're very warm. As you can see, the steam coming off it right now. For a sea day, it's not too cold, is it, at the moment?
No, and there's also stations dotted around where there's pools or whirlpools or anything. So you've got towels.
Clean towel station.
Clean towels, and then you've got a used towel station as well where you can just get rid of it after.
Yeah, and also just down the sides of these ships, this deck has three other little whirlpools, not as big as that tiny ones on the side of the ship, either side. And then we've got the front of the ship where our cabin is. We can get nice views.
Yeah.
It gets very windy on sea days at the front of the ship. Like yesterday, we nearly got blown over a gale, didn't we?
Yeah.
So, let's continue the tour.
We are now on deck 7, and at the back of the ship, we have the other main dining restaurant, which is the Coral Restaurant. And one thing to note as well, on every deck, there are several toilets around, which is really handy. You don't have to go back to your room to use the toilet.
And this is the main shopping capital of the ship. So if you look through this way, through the Shop of Norway, just in the middle at the back, you have the loyalty and you have
the loyalty.
Yeah, so if you want to book your next cruise while you're here on a cruise, go to the loyalty thing. They can give you extra credit and load deposits. We inquired about Caribbean. We got £100 each deposit, as where online it would have been £728 deposit. And then you've got your Shore Experiences. We can book your Shore Experiences. Like if you go next port, you've got everything.
You've got basically duty free shops. You've got you can buy alcohol, which I believe that you can't. If you purchase it, you can't pick it up until maybe this last sea day or last night.
It depends. If it's alcohol, it is definitely. They'll do.
We've got like little clothes shops. We've got like a Mulberry shop, handbags. We've got jewellery. more jewellery.
Right, guys, if you come in here and your wife's going to batter your wallet, come prepared, because you can spend a lot of money here on a ship.
Yeah, and we also have another one that sort of does like perfumes and jewellery, watches, stuff like that.
And then we've got a perfume and aftershave one just opposite. And then we've got an electronic shop.
Electronic shop. Speakers. Or if you forget anything, basically.
Yeah, and then we've got on another side. So just round here before, because we're on the opposite side, some things are different. This is a photo hub. If you get any photos taken on gala night, just come along here. All the photos will be stored. Just put your room number in and you can get your, they're quite expensive. It's like £25 for a photo and they do up to 10 photos for like £100. To put them on a USB or you can have them printed. You can do little frames. And then where we just showed you a minute ago across the hall, there's the perfume shop down there.
There's lots of sort of duty-free shops if you fancy a bit of shopping whilst you're on board.
Yeah, lots.
So this area here is the reception area. You'll come here for any queries that you might have or
problems with my holiday app, any extra charges just done on your bill,
just anything basically. And this is Dame Irene Hayes, who named Iona back in 2021.
Yes, it's May 2021, a maiden. Yeah, I don't think a maiden voyage was till April 2022.
We also have Cellar Door at the Glasshouse. Yep. So this is the Glasshouse restaurant. A bit strange because it's in the atrium, but
it's very nice. Yeah,
yeah, it's very nice. We haven't eaten here. They don't do many sort of vegetarian options, so we've just chosen not to eat at this restaurant.
No, but it is very nice. It's always busy, this one.
So we're still in the grand atrium. As you can see, you've got the impressive stairs. One thing I didn't say actually as well, we've not shown yet, is there is a Pandora shop. So if you into Pandora charms, they have an exclusive ship.
Yeah.
Pandora charm, which is really sweet. We're coming up now to the casino. I'm not sure if I should film in here, to be fair.
Yeah, you can film in here, it's fine. There's one person gambling already at 6:30 in the morning, so.
Yeah.
And then just to our right, they do a lot of quizzes here, and Brody's do like Brody's Challenge movie themed quizzes, individual quizzes. Not that we're any good at them, because we're pretty shit, to be honest. Like, yeah, we'll do them. We'll get like 2 right out of 20, so.
They're good fun, though.
Fun. Yeah.
Especially on sea days when, you know, there's so much to do. They often do a few quizzes a day, don't they?
Yeah. There's a pool table here. We had rough seas yesterday. I wouldn't recommend. They had a killer pool challenge. I mean, we had quite a rough 35 knot wind, so the balls would just move around the table. So they do loads of, there's loads of stuff you can do in the horizon. And then obviously we've got the main casino bit. And then just in front of us where you see the red lights, that is the, we're at the top part of the Headliners Theatre, where you can come in and view the shows, all that kinds of other stuff you can do. Towards the front end of the ship, we have a place called Scene here in front of us. This is for the teenagers, you can drop them off during the day, do loads of fun different things.
Yeah, and it's for 13 to 17 year olds.
Yep, so no bigger than that because they're classed as adults apparently. So if we walk this way, you will see we have the Oasis Health Spa. Now this is open on your embarkation day. You can go in there, it's free to look around. You can have a look at the hydrotherapy spa, the sauna. And then just before we go, so the Headliners Theatre is on deck 6 and 7. This is the bottom entrance. The top one will be on the next floor, we'll show you that. But a lot of the shows are here. You will have to book some of the shows on the horizon. There'll be a little icon of a smiley face. That means you need to book through the My Holiday app to get a seat. Some of them don't have to, like at Sea Days, they'll do game shows. Like we've had Deal or No Deal and Wavelength. You don't have to book them, you just turn up and show up. The earlier you get there, the better. And then as we come down here, as you can see, this is the art gallery area. And we've just had an unveiling by Mr. Brainwash. And they do change his paintings quite regularly, and they're very nice paintings. I think this is Mr. Brainwash. This is, some of them go for like £20. You can buy these paintings as well, actually, and they're pretty funky. It's quite nice when you're walking along the ship and they just show you different paintings. And then this floor will lead you to the Limelight Club, which you can book your 3-course dinner. They have a musician here. We haven't actually been here, so we can't show you anything in the Limelight, unfortunately. And then this part will lead you to the main atrium. As we're up early on the ship, this is the grand atrium area on deck 6. We have a lovely sunrise at the moment for our sea day. So we're up very early doing this. This is, you can get your Costa Coffee, do snacks. The snacks are not included with the food on the ship because it's part of Costa Coffee. It will be extra chargeable to your room.
We've got one of the bars here.
Yeah.
We've got one of the bars here, which is called the Emerald Bar. This gets really busy of an evening. So if you want a seat, I'd probably recommend coming down a little bit earlier. And a lot of people do sit and look out to see. Yeah, it's beautiful here.
They do buskers over here. So basically over in that corner, you get like a little busker or a singer or a pianist. Got the piano over there playing. Also, on gala nights and some other nights, they'll show you where the photographer's doing their sessions. If you're here on your first celebration night, a gala night, whatever you want to call it, this spot is probably one of the prettiest. And the cinema. Over on the right hand side, you have the harbour shop. This is open on your sea days and half an hour after you leave port. We have the 710 Club just over here on your left. We haven't been there at all, but there's not a lot of room in there, so you do have to get there early if you do want a seat. Another part where we are, this is, when I mentioned about when they do photographers, this is probably one of the nicest areas where you'd be able to get a photo at night. And then obviously when you first do come here, we have four screens. Now the screen information can be found down there when the seats are available, but as I do, they do change these films every day and you can see all the show times along here. This area is beautiful. I'd recommend if a photographer's doing a photo shoot here, get yourself queued up and get yourself a photo. Try and get yourself a photo when people are not going to the cinema, you'll get a really good shot. And on this deck, we've got some of the restaurants down here. So we've got Anderson's Bar and Library. Obviously it has his own bar, and just to the right here you can actually rent books to read and you can drop them off in a drop box. So this is quite nice. This can get busy on sea days. We had a cancelled port yesterday at Hargesund, so everywhere on the ship was really busy. And this is one of the main dining rooms. There's four of them. This is the Aqua restaurant, which is on deck 6 towards past midship towards the aft. So you can come here and then you can book. This is all booked through the My Holiday app. It's open for breakfast, lunch and dinner. In our opinion, this one's probably like the worst to do sitting in. So we go head on down here. There's two more main dining rooms, I believe, down here. So we have just where this sign is in front of us here. This is the Opal restaurant, main dining room, just like the Aqua. You just book on the My Holiday app. And just down the end here, you have the Coral restaurant. Finally, but not least, we have the Gym Health Club here down on deck 5. This is one of the only things you'll find here in the lower decks, all the rest are cabins. And each cabin area will have like, there'll be a laundrette. If you've enjoyed our ship tour today and it's helped you, we haven't been in a lot of stuff, but I really do hope this helped you. Make sure you hit the like button and subscribe. Make sure you stick around for our future trips and don't miss a thing.
Yeah, and if you've got any questions or just say hi in the comments, we really appreciate your comments.
We'll try and ask us and we'll try and help you. If not, we'll just be like, I don't know. But yeah, with that being said, we'll see you soon for our Singapore and Bali vlogs.
See you soon. Bye. Bye.